The 4.0 update is here, and with it came Hero from Dragon Quest. And oh ho, by just looking at this character, I already noticed that Sakurai literally took Link, Pikachu, Ike, Samus, Cloud, Joker, you know what, just take the entire 76 roster and just press it into one single character. The final boss in the story mode can easily be replaced with this new monster of a character. You are thinking by now, come on Pez, aren't you overreacting just a little bit? No. You know what? In this video, I'm going to show you a quick analysis and let you decide what rank Hero will take in the tier list. Movement. Hero's movement speed is similar to Link and has the same weight and gravity as Ike. As for normal attacks and frame data, what can I say? They are just amazing. I love it. His down tilt combos into a lot of stuff. He has a down throw into a kill confirm back air, forward air, and a down air spike if positioned correctly. His F smash kills at 60% and it has a, let's say, 30% crit chance, which kills at 40%. 40%. The only negative thing I could mention is that his forward air and back air have a little bit of a startup frames. But aside from that, he's actually really good. Every combo leads at least to a 20% damage combo. His forward tilt blocks projectiles and it also prones the opponent. And it can be followed up with a second attack, just like Snake's forward air, which is a kill confirm at 120% near the ledge, or just anywhere close to the edge. Still not convinced. There is more. All right, this is where it gets spicy. This part of the analysis will make you go,
why?
As for his neutral B, he fires a fireball with a ridiculous amount of range. And on top of that, this attack kills at 80%. His up creates a whirlwind that launches him vertically into the air, just like Revali's Gale in Breath of the Wild. And Link still has his Generation 1 spin attack recovery. I can hear the disappointment of all the Breath of the Wild Link mains. I'll feel your pain. While charging this recovery in midair, you lose some falling speed, as you can see right here. So no matter how low you are, you will always make it back. Next, we got his side special. Oh, his side special is the creme de la creme of Hero. If you tap it, you will send a electric strike, let's say, and send the enemy flying. If you charge it into stage 2, it will have some extra knockback and some extra range. And on stage 3, you will unleash a force of destruction upon their lives and their kin and send you right back into the darkest realms of depression. Because, ladies and gentlemen, this move kills at 45%. Isn't that amazing, right? Oh, I'm gonna need a drink after this one. Oh, God. Disgusting. Lastly, we got his down special. His down special is a wide collection of buffs, ridiculous strong attacks, and heals. Yeah, he can heal himself for 11%. I'm going to need a deep breather for this one, because this guy has 20 spells in his arsenal to destroy your life. So let's go. Oomph! Temporarily increases the hero's attack power, however, it also slightly decreases the hero's defense. Snooze, a forward moving projectile that sends the opponent to sleep if it connects. The projectile grows larger as it travels, but puts the opponent to sleep for longer at close range. Unlike Sync, Snooze can affect aerial opponents. Wait, what? Snooze can affect aerial? What?
What?
Bounce. Imagine how OP it would be if someone could walk around for 10 seconds with a Fox or Falco Shine. Oh, wait. Flame Slash. A quick slash with the hero's sword cloaked in flame deals considerable damage and knockback. Caracal Slash. PK freeze, but then as a close range attack. Kaklang. The hero surrounds himself with metal and is immune to all attacks except Metal Slash. So the only counter to this attack is another hero player that uses Metal Slash. Zoom. Causes the hero to fly up vertically from everywhere before coming down back into the center of the stage. Kamikaze. Causes the hero to self-destruct after a long charging animation. This attack kills the opponent at 50% and higher. Sizz, a flame projectile sent forward. Sizzle, a flame projectile sent forward quickly. Psych up, dramatically increases the knockback dealt by the hero's next attack while only slightly increasing the damage. This attack can kill someone at 0% if used on a forward smash. Heal, heals the hero for a small percentage, 11%. Accelerate. Temporarily buffs the hero movement speed by a significant amount, similar to lightweight. It also makes the hero easier to launch. Bang. A small explosive flaming projectile sent forward. Deals decent knockback. Kaboom. Bang, but more knockback, more damage. Hatchet Man. A forceful downward slash set to deliver a critical hit. Whack sends any enemy above 80% back to the Shadow Realm. Twack, similar to Whack, except the attack is delivered as a large close range explosion. Hocus Pocus, a spell with random effects, both positive and negative, and also can take the form of other command selection spells. Magic Burst, a powerful and massive blast that hits multiple times and is active for a few seconds. So edge guarding is no problem with this spell. This spell is a guaranteed edge guard, I can assure you that. As for my final verdict, I honestly think this character is still broken. I know his aerials and his neutral game is not that strong. He's actually pretty slow, actually. His forward air comes out frame 17 or frame 18, something like that. But still, all hero needs is 3 hits and he can kill you. You're at danger at 45-50%, and this is not a Ganondorf Dorian meme that you have to like hit someone for, I don't know, for a fully charged up smash attack or just a normal smash attack. No, this guy can drop a fireball at 50%. He can drop a forward smash uncharged because he can crit. Uncharged forward smash and you're dead. He can throw a forward B or forward special, whatever you want to call it. He can throw that at you and you will die at 45%. Close to the edge or even at the middle of the stage depending on your weight. And let's not talk about his unpredictable RNG killing down B. His down B is ridiculous. He has a choice of 20 spells that can completely destroy you above 70%. Anything above 70%, your life is in danger. And edge guarding with this guy is absolutely dumb. It's just unfair. All he has to do is throw out a fire slash or a mana burst and you cannot recover. If you roll, you die. If you try to two frame it, you die because it like the effect lingers. And if you try to get up and shield, you don't have enough time to do that because you will get blasted away. So overall, my overall opinion about this character is this guy is ridiculously OP, and he will most likely get nerfed within the next upcoming patch. If you liked the video, make sure to like and subscribe and comment down below what you think about these type of videos. Would you like to see more of them, or should I just go back to fast action montage videos? Let me know. Thank you, and I will see you guys on the next adventure.